Well, it was built when Australia first hosted the Olympics back in 1956 and has been employing Sydneysiders ever since. Now the Kurnell Oil Refinery's days are numbered.
And that means hundreds of jobs that families depend on are being axed. Lachlan Kennedy and Jacqueline Maddock have been at Kurnell all day covering this important story. To Lachlan first. And Lachlan, it is fair to say it's been a difficult day.
Sandra, it's very fair to say that. In fact, you could say the difficulty has been compounded by the fact that we in the media knew about this closure before the workers did. Now, the union says that shows Caltex has been misleading its staff, but the company is adamant everyone knew it was taking a very close look at this facility.
With their future in the pages they clutched, hundreds of Caltex Kurnell workers slowly emerged from a morning meeting they wished they never had.
There is no doubt the reality of this decision will be difficult for them.
The ageing South Sydney refinery will shut in late 2014, just shy of its 60th birthday. The closure will cost 330 full-time jobs and hundreds of contract and casual positions.
This is bad news this morning for around 700 working people.
This company is simply going to cut and run.
The site will be converted to an import terminal to receive fuel from Singapore and India.
Our refineries are small in scale. Just to give you an idea, the average Australian refinery is about 100,000 barrels a day. The ones in the region that we are competing with are of the order of 500,000 to 1.2 million.
Shell has already announced its Clyde refinery will close in September, leaving New South Wales reliant on foreign oil, and workers here asking,
where is Barry O'Farrell?
Losing one major industrial oil refining capability is careless. But losing two in 12 months just shows you're not on the field and you're not interested.
Caltex claims its refinery business lost $280 million last year. A recent review blamed Kurnell for the hemorrhaging. Unions claim they were told there was still hope to save this plant and a decision wouldn't be made until a board meeting tomorrow.
At 3 p.m. this afternoon, I'd be meeting with the CEO to have a discussion about the future of this refinery.
The company says it will pay staff full entitlements, but the union's are vowing to fight, meaning the uncertain ride will continue for workers.
Now, the one thing everyone wants to know is what will this mean for petrol prices? Well, the union is adamant they will have to rise because we're relying more on imported product. But both Caltex and, importantly, the federal government agree that won't be the case because our pump prices are already set by foreign exchanges as well as the market competition.
Lachlan Kennedy, thank you.
So let's go to Jacqueline Maddock now, who's at a popular local watering hole where a few staff are drowning their sorrows tonight. Jackie, this must have been pretty hard for the workers today.
Absolutely, Sandra. The refinery at Kurnell has been the main employer of the community here for almost 60 years, and pretty much every family that we met and spoke to today is tied or connected to it in some way. Now, as you mentioned behind me, the rec club here has been filling up with Caltex workers. They've been shuffling in all afternoon since knockoff at about 3:15. They're sharing some drinks and they're sharing in their disappointment. They can't talk to us on camera because Caltex has issued a gag order. In fact, staff have been told if they do speak to the media, they face instant dismissal. We did, however, meet one brave gentleman that is so betrayed, feels so upset with Caltex that he was willing to defy them, even though he's worked there for 30 years.
I've told the wife and yes, we really have to re-examine our life. We'll probably be selling our home. We can't afford to live in Australia's dearest city when we haven't got a job.
Now, sadly, that's exactly how so many of these people are feeling today. And what's worse is these Caltex workers are just the latest in a string of mass sackings in both the private and public sector. And they now join the ever-growing list of jobless in New South Wales.
Jackie Maddock, thank you.